Hi, this is Karen McKee, the scientist videographer. The GoPro Hero is a great camera for action filming such as skiing, surfing, and mountain biking. However, there are lots of other ways to use this versatile camera. I recently tried out my GoPro Hero 3 Black Edition in some tide pools on Kangaroo Island in South Australia. With the GoPro, I could put the camera underwater and film in really shallow tide pools. I could also capture footage of the swirling water and sand as each wave rolled into the tide pool. You may be a nature enthusiast or photographer with a new GoPro, or you may be a student or scientist studying the marine environment. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to set up your GoPro to film in a shallow water setting, such as a tide pool or even your backyard swimming pool. To assemble the GoPro for underwater filming, you will of course be using the underwater housing that comes with your camera. Of prime importance is to ensure that you have the solid lid attached to your housing and not the skeleton door. Also, clean the lens on the camera as well as the corresponding areas on the housing. You don't want a smudge or a piece of lint messing up your footage. Put the camera into its waterproof housing and ensure it's seated properly. Check the gasket to make sure it's free of sand, hair, and other debris. Close the lid and double-check the seal to make sure it's seated properly. I recommend setting your camera up in a clean, dry environment. Once you get out and start filming in tide pools or other underwater situations, you don't want to open up the underwater housing again unless you have to, for example, to change out the battery. I'll go through a few suggestions about that a bit later. For now, let's go into the camera settings. First, let's look at the video settings. I use 1080p, 30 frames per second, and medium view. You can certainly go for a higher resolution if you want, but keep in mind that it will take more memory. 1080p is high definition and a good choice to start off. You can shoot at 30 frames per second or some other setting, for example 60 frames per second if you are planning to later show some portion of your footage in slow motion. If not, 30 frames per second will do. The next setting is field of view. Medium or wide mode will probably work for most situations. You might want to try both and see what works best. The last setting is the low light option. In most cases, there will be plenty of light in a tide pool, so leave this turned off. If you also plan to shoot still images, then you want to set this up as well. You have four basic choices with combinations of field of view and image size. I usually go with something that will be a good resolution but not take up too much memory, such as 7 wide. Let's take a quick look at the capture settings. In here you have the option of flipping the view upside down. This comes in handy if you have your GoPro on the end of a pole and will be shooting with the camera upside down. If so, then turn this option on. Then your footage will be right side up when you edit. Otherwise, leave it off. Turn spot mode off. This will cause the camera to evaluate the entire scene to get the best exposure overall. Next is looping, which you want off unless you need this option for some reason. Finally, turn ProTune off. If you have ProTune turned on, this will require more effort when you try to edit your footage later. And those are the basic settings. If you're planning to dive with your GoPro, then you might want to use a filter to correct for the lighting at deeper depths. But for snorkeling and in tide pools, a filter is not necessary. Now let's look at a few different ways to film in a tide pool. First, you can just hold the camera in your hand and dip it into the water, moving it around for different perspectives. That's what I'm doing here. The main downside to this approach is that it can be difficult to hold the image horizontal and steady, and also you might have problems keeping your fingers out of the field of view. You're basically going to be shooting blind, which makes it difficult to frame up the scene or organisms that you wish to film. It may take some trial and error to get what you want. One important consideration is that the GoPro has a minimum focusing distance of 12 inches. Any closer and the object will be blurred. Another option is to attach your GoPro to a pole and then you can dip it into the water. Now, I've made this pole out of PVC pipe, as you can see, and I put an attachment on the end that I can fit the mount that holds the camera at one end. I've also made some extra sections so that I can lengthen the pole if I need to. So this approach is going to require that you flip the view upside down in the capture settings. Now, if there's a chance that you may lose your grip on your camera or it comes loose for some reason, it may be a good idea to attach a tether directly to your camera and then attach the tether to yourself so your camera is protected. An alternative is to exchange out the back lid with another lid to which you've attached a float. And you can get these from GoPro. And that fits right on here. And if your camera comes loose, the float will bring your camera to the surface of the water. Another option is to set your GoPro up on a tripod like this. And then all you have to do is set it down into the bottom of the pool. And you can angle your camera up or down, however you need to set it. This is a great way to capture time-lapse film in a tide pool. Perhaps you're interested in shooting a time-lapse of an organism, for example. This is what you would want to use to make sure that your camera is steady throughout all of the shots that will be taken with the camera. What if you need to open up the housing for some reason? For example, to change out the battery. Well, you want to be really careful about not letting any water, particularly seawater, touch your camera. So the first thing to do is to rinse your camera off in fresh water. You can submerge it in a bowl like this or just pour water over it. Then you want to shake off as much of the water as you can. And then using a clean, dry towel, dry off the housing. And then once you've got most of the water droplets off, then set your camera down in the air and let the rest of the moisture on the outside of the housing evaporate. Then you can open the housing and take out your camera. Once you're sure there's no moisture and your hands are dry, open the housing and quickly change out the battery. Note that even taking these precautions, you may have fogging problems later, so you might want to pop in two or three anti-fog inserts. Well, those are a few basic instructions on how to set up your GoPro Hero camera to shoot in a tide pool or some other shallow underwater setting. For more tips and tutorials, please check out my ebook. And thanks for watching.